We are approximately killing 300 bee colonies every day in Bangalore. People are paying 1,500 to 2,000 rupees to kill the bees. The same amount can be collected to save the bees. Do we have such resources? Do we have that response team? That is the question.
My name is Apurva and I am a director of Honeyday Bee Farms. And I have been doing beekeeping since 11 years now. I teach beekeeping to farmers, hobbyists, naturalists. I am from Chitradurga, 200 kilometers from Bangalore. It's a very small place, small town. In India, with respect to bees, we don't have much reference. We may have a lot of references for honey in Ayurveda and many, many other spaces. But we don't have references for significance of bees and beekeeping. So I started to observe bees a lot. How they reacted to seasons, how they reacted to challenges, predators. And we are providing farmers a solution where pollination can go for rental basis. Whenever a farmer is requiring a pollination, we give our beehive boxes in a rental basis where farmers can hire boxes and place it in their farm, get the pollination and return it.
Farmers will know how many loads of composting should be done per acre. But do they know how many bees are required per acre? There are a few animals which are required in our ecosystem. I will say required, but actually they are existent for some purpose. Even these hornets, which are robbing my bees, they are also required for some purpose. I may control them by putting that whatever stick I have put over there. I may control something like this. I should not be killing them. I should not search their nest and burning them.
For the better pollination, you may have to keep 2 to 3 beehives per acre. So that is how agriculture and beekeeping and honeybees can go along. So in Honeyday Bee Farms, now we have made this company for beekeepers. We not only give them technology to enhance their good practices, we also aggregate honey from them. So when we buy back honey from them, there will be a close association between us and bee farmers. And we can really understand bee farmers because we are also bee farmers. We collect around 22 varieties of honey in a year from across country, from Northeast to Rajasthan, from South India, all the way to Kanyakumari. We collect a lot of honey. We produce our own honey in Karnataka with eucalyptus, sunflower, tur, sesame, safflower. After we bringing honey, we will put them to some sections by planning, because we will not be bringing honey only from one farmer. We will be bringing from many other farmers. Honey is harvested in the farms. The food grade containers will be loaded to the trucks and the truck will come to our factory. Even when you harvest honey, you should not be harvesting 100%. If there are 8 frames of full of combs, full of honey, we leave 1 or 2 frames for them and we take away only 6 frames. We use muslin cloth, which is tied to a small vessel. We pour it. We will pour it on the cloth and it will get filtered. Honey is having a lot of shelf life. Even the raw honey, where the moisture is less than 18%, you can keep it forever. most of the time consumers are not educated and they will never know where the honey is coming from. So everything is encapsulated in the name of good branding. And so most of the honey which you will get in the commercial packing and big brands, they will pressurize when they filter. It can take out everything, even the pollen. So you will have more protein and more nutritional value if you have pollen in it. So that's why we use only muslin cloths and we filter. One drop of honey will have 30,000 pollen grains in it. So it's a very simple process. We also have outreach beekeeping program where we buy back honey from outreach beekeepers. And we provide an ecosystem of beekeeping by going to a new place. So when there will be an invite from a good source, we go there, we develop an ecosystem by doing capacity building projects with tribal communities, rural communities. And we have our own manufacturing of all beekeeping equipment. Beekeeping equipment is an important factor for beekeepers, because on farm there will be requirement for even the tiny tool for beekeeping. If you don't have the tool, you may not have the efficient way of doing beekeeping. So we produce all those things. Few of the things we produce are in our own factory, few of the things we produce it through some other fabricators. So we bring in wood, which is acacia, pine, teak, because we don't have heavy machinery in our factory. All we have is cross-cutting machines where we can trim it and shape it and cut it to desirable dimensions. We cut pieces from sawmill itself. And the cut pieces will come to our factory and we will trim it, we will cut it to desirable dimensions and we will nail it. And we make our own frames, because frames are the most important part of beehive boxes. So in frames we will have to preserve bee spacing, the space between one comb to another comb. Space between one comb to another comb is called bee spacing. For Apis cerana, there is a different bee space. For Apis mellifera, there is a different bee space. Whatever understanding we have, especially in the urban space, it's only fear about bees. So that fear is killing them. So whenever you see a very big beehive in your building, people will call pest control companies. So pest control companies will come spray, kill, and they will take money. Our own people in our country, they are killing our own bees and paying them. That is the angle that which you have to see.